The project that we're working on aims to deploy teams of robots into underground environments to have send them into places that we might not want to send people, to have them basically perform a game of scavenger hunt. So there's a series of objects that we're supposed to find autonomously and relay that information back to an operator who's safely at the opening of the cave.
So the robot sends back two really key pieces of information. So it sends back its path and a 3D map of what its past looks like, and it sends locations and pictures of the artifacts that it's detected. So I have a 3D picture of the tunnel that's on my monitor, and I have a little 2D picture of this is the trajectory of the robot and this is where all the objects are, and I can click on an object and say, oh, that's what the robot thinks it looks like.
The two sides of robotics is taking computer programming and making it tangible. You see something move, you can feel something in your hands. And then on the perception side of it, robotics is such a great test of perception because we're not hand-picking images and saying, what can you do with this? We're letting the robot pick the images. And so you're losing control in that sense. And that makes it very challenging because most of engineering is about exerting control on the system and on the environment in which the system operates. And robotics forces you to release some of that.
Most of the systems we build in the laboratory are combinations of systems. So a legged robot involves a tremendous amount of mechanical design effort, but it also involves very sophisticated control, which comes from electrical engineering and mechanical engineering. On top of that, it involves perception. So we need all the skills that computer science brings to bear on these kinds of problems, not to mention planning, communication, coordination, and the like. So it's an extremely broad spectrum problem, and it really involves bringing together a team of people with multiple different skills and getting them to work towards a common goal.
The biggest takeaway for me, and I think for most of the team, has been how many challenges of robotics are, as one of the other guys said, like the last 10%. It's like, how do you make something robust enough and reliable enough to work in unknown environments reliably with a lot of time crunch without being able to sort of do all this fine tuning that people generally do?
Legged locomotion really can be seen as a continuum. I mean, you start off walking with robots that walk on kind of nice, flat, carpeted ground, and then you're moving towards slightly rougher terrain, and now you're starting to talk about boulders, and now you're talking about train tracks, and so on. So it's not so much that you hit a point of frustration in a problem like that, it's that you're continually getting to one point and then looking beyond and saying, oh, the robot does this now. Now can it do this? Now can it do this? Now can it do this? So it's more in the nature of trying to constantly expand the capabilities of your system and deal with more and more of what the real world throws at you.